Immunites TV with head football coach Mark Henninger as 2019 National Signing Day is upon us. Coach, another great season last year, undefeated regular season, and you come into this recruiting season here trying to get some new players to keep that good thing going. When you enter recruiting season, you and your staff, what are your overall goals?
Well, every recruiting year kind of takes on a life of its own. You know, you really have to look at not just replacing what you lost, but also kind of looking at, we call it the landscape, kind of looking at really position by position, how many more years each one of those guys has left. And you know, you want to avoid having to go out and fill a huge, you know, fill huge gaps and huge voids in your recruiting. So you always want to have, you know, you never want those cupboards to go bare. You know, you always want to have, you know, the, you know, reserves and guys ready to step in, the next man up type mentality. So, you know, as we looked at this year's class, you know, obviously we didn't lose a lot of seniors, you know, off our team last year. I still think that, you know, we were really a pretty young football team a year ago. But looking at, you know, we're likely to take some recruiting hits here over the next two years. So trying to get ourselves in position to where, you know, we've got guys ready to go here. You know, now we'll have some guys come in, I'm sure, and compete right away for this fall. But the majority of these guys, we're looking at the future, trying to make sure that we're good for years to come.
You have the benefit of coaching a university right in the heart of Indianapolis, but this state really puts a premium on their high school football and hiring quality coaches. That has to be a welcomed sight for you when you go hit the recruiting trail.
Well, it makes the job a lot easier for us. I mean, we don't have to go, you know, while we have some guys coming from other states, we don't really feel like we have to go anywhere else to put together a team that's capable of competing at the highest level. So, you know, we are fortunate. There's outstanding high school coaches in this state, and it just seems to get better and better every year. Football is important. Indiana for years was just a basketball only state, and you know, the athletes are getting better. The schools are putting, you know, resources into, you know, developing their students and developing their athletes, and obviously the football programs here in our state, and, you know, especially here in central Indiana, continue to get better and better and better. So, you know, we're very fortunate that, you know, there's an abundance of talent, you know, in our area that that can play at our level and play at a high level. So, you know, while we venture into Ohio, and I think we're getting better and better in Ohio, you know, our coaches have done an outstanding job finding the right talent. We've been very well received by the high school coaches there in Southwest Ohio. We've crept over into Illinois here a little bit, and you know, it's been really, really good. But, you know, without question, our backyard, you know, we consider Indiana, we got to do a great job in Indiana, and we feel like as long as we continue to do a great job in Indiana, we'll always be competitive.
Let's break this class down offensively. We'll start there. Currently, you look at who's coming back, and kind of like you said, there's a lot coming back. Mm-hmm. But what were some of the areas you wanted to address offensively?
Yeah, I think, you know, looking at the big thing, again, looking down the road at the future, I mean, obviously we graduated, you know, a couple really good offensive linemen. We graduated a great tight end. We graduated an outside receiver. You know, so obviously right away you're looking at there's some spots there that we have to fill. You know, we've done a good job here. It seems like every recruiting class is a little bit better than the one before it. So that's really brought about some great competition. So, you know, I think we felt like we had to answer some of those questions. But again, looking down the road, at, you know, we'll have, you know, I mean, we'll have two quarterbacks entering this year as seniors, and they've both taken 99% of the snaps here the last 3 years. So obviously we had to answer that question. And you know, same thing with running backs. We've got some offensive linemen that are getting ready to cycle out and cycle through. So, you know, we felt like we had to really, there was not one particular position we felt like we really needed to focus on. And I think our coaches did an outstanding job at recruiting for need and, you know, getting really a pretty balanced selection of players across the board.
Defensively, you guys have the number one defense in the country and just thoroughly dominated quite a few games last year. What did you need to address on that side of the ball?
Yeah, really same thing. I mean, we graduated, you know, Chad Skaggs. Now, again, he was was the defensive player of the year in our league, and we graduated one of our corners. So, looking at immediate needs for this upcoming fall, I mean, it wasn't like we felt like we had huge, huge holes that we had to answer. However, there are, we do have some depth issues in some of our positions that we really felt like we needed to go out and answer. And again, really this, not just on defense, but all across the board, we're looking for longer, athletic type guys. And I think we did a really good job of filling those needs.
To hear Coach Henninger's full breakdown by position of this class, click on the next video on MUnites.com.